Greetings and welcome to Spider-Man Gownforge channel. This time, Kabuki Quantum Fighter. The cartridge is in playable condition, although we will take it apart and clean those contact pads. Make sure there's no wear along the cartridge board, wear line, and all that. So I'm going to go ahead and touch that up right now and clean it. Down in the comments section down below, why don't you guys tell me, have you ever had a chance to play Kabuki Quantum Fighter? I had the chance to do so back in the day. And I was just saying, I couldn't get very far, but for the amount of time that I did play it, I absolutely loved and still do love this game. See, that's the reason why we clean out the munchie catch. Yeah, I call it the munchie catch because when you're playing video games and you're eating a lot of chips, you get that residue on your fingers, and that's where that goes right here, the munchie catch. Because you could be swapping out games here and there. I mean, if you have a collection of them, you play one and then you're like, let's move on to the next one. But yeah, Kabuki. I mean, this game is so awesome. The background art all's animated when you're going through. You can see like everything's moving, and I really like it a lot. It's been visually appealing. How many other games do you know that your main protagonist can use his or her hair to destroy enemies? I love it. I love it. Yeah. That's really cool. Let's see. It definitely needs to be cleaned. So we'll definitely clean that. I don't see much of a wear. This side's usually the wore outside. Somebody definitely took care of this game. Before I get too far ahead of myself, let's do color coordinations. Light blue, blue, blue. And the best that we have for color red, right there. It looks kind of pink or something on here, but that's okay. That's my camera. You got it? I think you do. Boop. Was it made in 99 or made in 98? What did that say? Oh, 89. That's a long time ago, wasn't it? Yeah, this game is so advanced. I was like, it's gotta be like around the 90s. You know, somewhere around there. I wasn't thinking that it was actually made in 89. Cool. Let's get busy. Let's clean it up. Give me a second here. Now you can see what I'm doing here. I'll just move the media. Make sure you wear your safety glasses. And I will be using this particular electric eraser to break it all up. And then I will use another eraser to collect it within it. Media. Oh, there's a little. Oh, okay, it's just a bridge there anyway, so it's not gonna make a difference if we do have a little bit of damage there. I could always touch it up with some no chip or some conformal coating. Yeah, not much is coming off, which is great because I keep my cartridges as clean as possible. Even when I get them right away, I wipe them down before I even put them inside of a console to play them. I just think it's a really good idea. I really don't want to reintroduce garbage from a dirty, really filthy cartridge. I mean, I'm sure you guys have seen what I'm talking about. Just gnarly, and when you put it back into the console, you're just reintroducing it back and forth, and then not only will this cartridge be dirty, but the next one that you put in there will be added to it too. Like, it'll transfer over. It's almost like a compact disc or a lens, you know, something like that, trying to keep it clean. And that's what these, that's what I'm trying to do with this. Getting a little bit low there, and I really, really don't like it getting that close to the for metal on metal contact. So it shrunk back down again. So I have to bend this together some more. Some touch-ups with this. I'm glancing back and forth to the camera too, making sure that I have all this in frame. So all this is catching right here and collecting it. It's getting whatever material was in between the contact pads too, and getting it all cleaned up to boarding. So that now when I sweep it off with the con swab, it's not going to be all like finish my sentence before I cut it off there. Streaking. It'll leave like a slick of whatever previous cleaners or some other material. There's like even wet eraser residue. Not all contact pads will shine up and be a mirror, and we've had other cartridges that way too. Miwoo. She likes to be center of attention whenever I'm doing these things. Thank you. looks actually really good. Now I have a previous video up of playing Kabuki Quantum Fighter through emulation, and the emulation side of things, it was a little glitchy here and there, and yeah, it's like, not one of my favorite games to emulate. That's why I like it on the cartridge. It just took me a little bit to get to these, because I've been working on a lot of other reviews. Why don't you guys tell me in the comment section down below whether or not you've beaten this one. Kabuki Quantum Fighter. I've beaten it through emulation with a lot of codes, but otherwise, no, I have not beaten this game. Alright, give me a second, I'm going to go ahead and clean up. Hello everyone, I'd just like to say thank you all so very much for subscribing to the channel and following me on other social media networks. It's greatly appreciated. I never thought it was ever going to go this far. It's incredible, and it's all because of you. You guys are doing it. Giving me the inspiration to find new things to work on and clean, and yeah, really talk about these particular game titles and just reminisce simpler times playing some of these. One of these times I'll use a deoxit. Is it preservative after. I'm curious as to whether or not deoxit would work on these, or would it hinder its ability to conduct? You know what I mean? Like, it's that kind of cleaner. Be interesting. There we go, one click instead of two, like we have been doing. And I don't want to do that anymore. Yeah, what do you think? I know it's a little dull, but you can see that's the type of copper that it's going to be. You know, like almost stainless steel version of like brushed steel. Maybe like brushed copper. That's no joke. It really does work using the eraser and then buffing that out with a cotton swab. And these are the bamboo type too, so they're a renewable resource. And yet rigid enough to accomplish what I'm striving for, and that's to get these all really, really nice and polished back up again so that it'll last for another 30 years without having to worry about having a patina or a verdigris on any of the components. That looks really good. See yourself in it. Maybe a couple little nicks in here and there. A little more buffing on this side. I'm sure the friction helps too. Get a little warm. Very, very good. There we go. That's awesome. All right. So I'm going to put it back together again and test it out in the console. See you all in a little. Hey everyone, I am back, and I'm playing a quick game of Kabuki, Quantum Fighter. Already beat the first stage.
said it, dude.
Timed with only less than a minute, or about a minute. There's my one out. By far the furthest I've ever made it in this game. It's a good run. This control is awesome. Wow, see how much like that is? I'm using the 10 deck upskiller and the easy cap 286 for video capture. During emulation, the last bit of the game there that we just played, it didn't work properly, and it would be non-rendered areas in the map of the stage, and it made it rather difficult. definitely a death trap. Anyway. Thank you all so very much for watching. Be healthy, stay safe, happy gaming.